You are listening to this message from Jesus Pavilion, part of the RCCG network. We hope God will meet your need after listening to this message.
Let somebody shout a loud hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. I'm just believing God that there will be a time that we are not going to shy away and we are going to dance for our God. One of our services that we can render unto God is the heart that is full of praise, that is full of joy. And this is what God is after. Amen and amen in Jesus' name. Yeah. Father, we thank you for another opportunity to come to the throne of grace, to come to the throne of mercy. We pray, oh God, that you will speak to the speaker and to the hearer, oh God. And you will bring encouragement to a soul. You will bring peace to a mind. You will bring hope to the hopeless in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your double-edged sword be a time that we pierce and we bring solution to so many problems in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be the word that we encourage somebody online today. Let me be the one that will bring healing to somebody online today. Let me be the one that somebody will receive. I know that of the truth, my tomorrow will be okay. Thank you, our Lord, our God. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. And the people of the Lord say,
Amen.
Amen.
Church, once again this morning, and my hope and my prayer is that the Lord will touch you in the mighty name of Jesus. As we always say, that there is no barrier in the place of spirit. We stand in our home or we sit in our home and we pray to God and he hears us. The most important thing is our heart, is our mind, is the hope that we have, that as we call upon him, he will hear us. The title of this message is, There is Success Ahead. There is success ahead. And I want to reassure somebody that it doesn't matter how long you have failed before, success will come your way in the name of Jesus. It does not matter the day that you have experienced before. Success is coming your way in the mighty name of Jesus. It does not matter what is staring you in the face, the amount of bill, the amount of money, the amount of project. I can reassure you that as long as the Lord liveth, that his name has not changed, success will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Read
your Bible quickly to the book of Proverbs. Proverbs 16 verse 3. I will quickly read from Amplified Version and then I will read the Passion as well. It said, commit your works, this is Amplified, to the Lord, which means submit and trust them to him. Not just submit. When you submit to him, you must trust them that he is able to keep those work unto him. He said, and your plans will succeed. That is where I know that I have confidence that ahead the Lord will make your plan to come to success in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, if you respond to his will and guidance, so which means when you submit your plan to him, you've got to put yourself in a position where you will respond to his will, his guidance, his counsel, his talking in the mighty name of Jesus. If you the same verse, if you read it from the Passion Translation, it said, before you do anything, put your trust totally in God and not in yourself. put yourself, put your trust totally in God and not in yourself, then every plan you make will succeed. And I know that as we are going to go through the scripture to see the reason why we need to put our trust in Him, every plan that you and I are putting in place will come to success in the name of Jesus. It is going to be a time of success ahead and a time of testimony for you and your family. Can I have somebody online to give me evidence to say amen to that?
Amen.
Or when you are reading a statement or somebody is giving you an instruction, what can that mean to you? So most of when Almighty God Himself is the one speaking to you, what is that meaning to you? Yes, we can say that this passage or this book of Proverbs was written by Solomon, but it wasn't written by Solomon's wisdom. It was written by God through Solomon. You know, God always operates through human being, and that is why you see some people will go and start doing deliverance ministry, and it is the name of God, because God will operate, spirit will operate through human being. So God is a spirit and He always operates through human being that is a spirit or carry the same kind of spirit. So the word that you hear, because the word of God, it is what? It is powerful and it is creative. At the beginning, when the heart was without void and form in the book of Genesis, He spoke just one word. What did He say? He said, "Let there be light." And the light came. And it's just one word, let there be light, or three words, the way we want to look at it. And then the light came and the atmosphere started changing. And it started. So that is why I said the word of God is powerful and the word of God is creative. So there is nothing you lack. There is nothing you need. There is nothing you desire. As long as you put this to God and you use His word to back Him up, you will realize that that word is powerful and that word is creative. And that is why sometimes we pray for what we call creative miracle, where you see people with short leg and their leg will grow. That is God in action. According to John chapter 1 verses 1 to 3, John chapter 1 verses 1 to 3, in NLT, say, in the beginning, the word already existed, which means even before the creation of the world, He is already in existence and He was with the Father. I said, the word was with God and the word was God. He existed in the beginning with God. God created everything through Him, and nothing was created except through Him. I hope you understand the one that we refer to as word. This is our Lord Jesus Christ, the second Trinity Himself. So every time you carry your Bible, either in iPad or you carry your Bible physically, what you are carrying with faith or in faith as you believe is you are carrying the word of God. And that word of God is Jesus Christ Himself, the word that can bring breakthrough, the word that can bring salvation, the word that can pierce man heart, the word that can bring favor to you. And I am saying that everything I'm saying, it will come to you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So when word like this is spoken, different people, different audience receive it differently. Some can receive the word of God as an advice. So it's just an advice as I read it. Some can receive the word of God that is an information. Someone will say, oh, that word is just an information. It's just informing me what I can do and what I cannot do. Or some will see it as a command. If I ask you categorically, Proverbs 16:3, is it an advice? Is it an information? Or is it a command? To you, I didn't say answer it, but to me, I want to tell you that this is a command. So the word that I'm bringing to you today, it is not an information, you know, for you to consider. No. It is not, it is not an advice for you to consider. And it is not an information for you to be ignored. No, it is a command. And if you see this word as a command, the potent of the word that is the power, what is meant to do, what is meant to accomplish, you will accomplish it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Today you stand in a point where you either move forward ahead to your success or you stay where you are. You have been pursued to a point of no return. The enemy is not resting. So I am saying that they have chased you to a place of no return. But if I were you, you will use that word to say there is no return, there is no retreat, there is no surrender. Because success is ahead of you. In the game of football, for men that are online, you know, there's something we call final. And in that final, before you get to the final, there's a stage we call elimination match. Someone must move ahead while others drop down. I am saying to you that you will not be the one to drop down in the name of Jesus. You will be the one promoted to the next stage in the name of Jesus. I say you will be promoted in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not die before you fulfill the destiny in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Psalm 118 verse 17. He said, I shall not die but live, and I declare the works of the Lord. The testimonies of what the Lord has done for you is the work of the Lord. And that is what I'm saying to you, that somebody online here, somebody that can hear me, your success is just as close as this. Success ahead is for you in the name of Jesus. Before the end of this year, you will record a merited favor in the name of Jesus. Before the end of this year, success on everything you lay your hands upon in the name of Jesus. Come on, let me hear somebody giving me a good evidence online in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The prayer for you today is to confirm to you that you are moving forward to the next level, moving forward to the other side of the Red Sea, moving forward to a place where there is plenty of milk and honey, moving forward on from slavery to more than abundant to total freedom.
Amen.
Moving forward from failure to success. Moving forward from sickness into health. So shall the Lord for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says sometimes when you read your Bible, you will see a portion that says, and Jesus moved across, or Jesus went ahead. Most especially in the book of Luke, Luke chapter 4, verse 31. I'm not going to read it, but in your own time, please do a study on it. Jerusalem is high up, and anyone that is going to move, you either move downward. And Jesus moved towards Jerusalem, while the disciples were there in Samaria, which is downward. I am sent to somebody. For you and your family, it is upward ever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is upward ever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the book of Genesis and Exodus, every time the Israelites backslide, what do? They go back to Egypt. For you, the door to Egypt is closed completely. You will not backslide. You will not backslide.
Amen.
Your family will not backslide. You will no longer be oppressed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every oppression of your life, every oppression of your destiny, it comes to an end in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Exodus chapter 19 verse 14. Exodus chapter 19 verse 14. We see when the man of God, Moses, was coming down from the mountain. He went down. You see, he's up and he had to come down to the people and then give them instruction. I am saying you will no longer be the one down. You will be the one up in the name of Jesus. And I'm not talking about the church. I'm talking about in whatever area of your world, you'll be ahead in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Isaiah 30:25 said, woe to those who go down to Egypt, for without consulting me, you have gone down to Egypt for help. You have put your trust in Pharaoh's protection. You have tried to hide in the shadow, but by trusting Pharaoh, you will be humiliated, and by depending on him, you will be disgraced. I am sent to somebody. All those people that you have been trusting for so long, that they have disappointed you, God is saying, do not put your trust in man. Put your trust in me. And that is why I say, woe to those that go to Egypt. And I am saying to you, you will no longer return to Egypt in Jesus' name. You are not a dog that should return back to the vomit. And that will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. God is saying to you and I, go forward. Say, I will go forward.
I will go forward.
Success is ahead of me.
Success is ahead of me.
In the book of Exodus chapter 14 verse 15, Exodus 14:15, the Lord said to Moses, why do you cry to me? tell the sons of Israel to move forward. So I am saying to you, do not look at man, do not look at bishop, do not look at GO. Go to God, and he will ask you to do what? To go forward. To go forward here could mean that, when did they say that? You remember when there was a host of Pharaoh behind, and the Red Sea was ahead of them, and the people are crying, people are jittering, people are looking at it and said, this is how we are going to end our life, so we will not get to the land that God has promised. God said to him, he said, why do you look at me? What else do I have to tell you? I am saying to you, move forward. That's why there is Red Sea ahead of them. And I am saying to somebody, don't look at that obstacle. That obstacle, in the name of Jesus, as you take the step of faith this morning, they will become your stepping stone to success. They will become your stepping stone to joy. They will become your stepping stone to a place of turnaround, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number one, there are about 6 points I want to quickly go through. Go forward here could mean that we should proceed to where he has determined to get to. His determination is to do what? Is to reach the land where God has promised them, the land that flows with milk and honey. I am saying to somebody, nobody will be able to prevent you from getting to your destination in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Year of your success in the name of Jesus. In the book chapter 1 verse 18, we saw the story of a young woman called Naomi and Ruth. When Naomi refused to go back, rather I was going forward with Ruth. And eventually, if you look at the genealogy of our Lord Jesus Christ, the name Ruth and Naomi were there because of his action of going forward. I am saying, as you take that decision to move forward with God today and not looking back to Egypt, in the name of Jesus, what he has not done for your family, the blessing that he has not done for you, the breakthrough that your family has never received, the prosperity that hasn't come to your life, to your family, the Lord will give unto you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And that is why, again, in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 30 verse 8, 1 Samuel chapter 30 verse 8, one of my popular scriptures when I'm talking about mission. And you see David here asking God, he says, should I chase after the bandits of Reda? Will I catch them? And the Lord said to him, yes, go after them. You will surely recover everything that has been taken from you. I am saying to somebody, as you go ahead this season, you will recover all in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beginning of this lockdown, it is time for you to recover all. It is time for your family to recover all. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are so many of us that in our heart and in our mind, we're determined to go higher. But the enemies have prevented us either through sickness, either geographical problem, or either lack of no job, or lack of no work, or lack of poverty, whatever they have used to tie you to the same place, I prophesy concerning you, it is time for you to go forward in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It takes what? It takes determination to go forward. It does not want you to go forward. But you've got to make a decision. You've got to stand in a position of Esther. If I perish, I perish. I must get to my room. This is the position of Brother Paul. If I perish, I perish. I must get to my Rome. Because to Brother Paul in those days, Rome is a seat of power. Rome is a place where Emperor Nero was. Rome is a place where he knows that whatever he puts his hand upon, the people will be able to hear him better. He'll be able to preach a better message of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he get to Rome. I am saying to somebody today, your determination to be free shall be granted in the mighty name of Jesus. Your determination to pass your exam shall be granted in the name of Jesus. Your
Amen.
To be married shall be granted in the name of Jesus. Your determination to have children Amen. Shall be granted in the name of Jesus. Your
Amen.
To Amen. Have property in this country shall be granted in the name of Jesus. Your
Amen.
Fully employed, it will be granted in the name of Jesus. Your
Amen.
Change the history of you and your family shall be granted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, what does go forward mean for you and I? For some people, it should mean never retreat, because to retreat is to go back to the camp of the enemy. If the Israelites had retreated, the host of Pharaoh are behind, which means they will go back. They have already tested the freedom, which means they will go back to the camp as a slave. That is not your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Exodus chapter 10. As Pharaoh approached, the people of Israel look up and panic. When they saw the Egyptians overtaking them, they cry out to the Lord. And I am saying to somebody, as you cry out to the Lord, he will hear your cry in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Your cry in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
One thing that makes you to retreat is the word fear. Fear, do not be afraid. According to Psalm 27, verse 1 to 4. Psalm 27, verse 1 to 4. It said, the Lord is my light and my salvation. So why should I be afraid? The Lord is my fortress, protecting me from danger. So why should I tremble? When evil people come down to devour me, when my enemies and foes attack me, they will stumble and fall. Though a mighty army surround me, my heart will not be afraid. Even when I am attacked, I will remain confident. The one thing I ask of the Lord, the one thing I seek most, is to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, delighting in the Lord's perfection, and meditating in his temple. Don't just read Psalm. Don't just read Bible for reading's sake. Read and imbibe what he's saying. Read and believe as you are reading. Ask the Holy Spirit to make that word to become real to you, to become reality to you. You will realize that you have nothing to be afraid of. Because that's what he has promised. This is not the time to turn back, because it is such a dangerous time. Many people in faith have turned back because they cannot cope with the pressure of life. They cannot cope with the pressure of COVID. In this period of COVID, that is when we know who is standing and who is not standing as a believer. Trust me, brother. You may not know this, but so many people have turned back at the faith. So many people have gone back to Egypt, the place where they can eat potato, where they can eat onions, where they can eat meat, where their things are being supplied free of charge. But we that we stand by God, he made a promise to us. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38 to 39. Hebrews 10, 38 to 39. It said, and my righteous ones will live by faith. But I will take no pleasure in anyone who turns back. That will not be your portion. He said, but we are not like those who turn away from God to their own destruction. We are the faithful ones whose soul will be saved. There could be a certain limitation that you have to do not to look back. I don't know what you have to put in place. Maybe you need to attend more prayer meeting. Maybe you need to attend more Bible studies. Maybe you need to upgrade your games. You have been just praying for 10 minutes each day. It is time for you now to go 20. You have been doing 30 minutes each day. It is now for you to double that and make it 1 hour. You have been doing 1 hour. Congratulations, but it is time for you to make it 1 hour, 30 minutes, 1 hour, and 2 hours. It is not too much to do. As I'm talking to you, I am talking to myself, because I got to a place where I feel guilty that I am not doing enough that I'm supposed to do. I'm a human being, but I am not accusing you. I'm accusing all of us as a believer, because God has made a promise and he will not look back, except if you and I are not pressing into what he has made available for you and I. But that will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. You may not have money in your pocket, and you are thinking that is the greatest challenge that is preventing you from moving forward. No, there's success ahead. Today, you may ask Pastor Yomi, you may ask the wife for help, you may ask this for help, you may ask that for help, and the help will come for you. That does not mean that you are a beggar. No, not in the eyes of the Lord. It just simply means God is saying, submit yourself, because I still have area where I need to walk in your life. Actually, you are bold to say that, or to ask for help when you need help. Many people are quiet, and as a result, they backslide. And then we hear that, oh, somebody has backslid. It is not what they do one day. It is a gradual process, but that will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. Because of our time.
Amen.
Number three, to go forward could mean the present obstacle, the Red Sea that you are seeing, shall be removed when you take the step of faith. when I was in my country and I was in the theater fully, there's always a challenge between the producer and the artist. The artist will be waiting for the producer to bring money. At the same time, the producer will be waiting for the artist to use his own money to do what we call pilot. And as a result, many projects will break down in between waiting for the money and using your own money to do a pilot, because you are afraid, if I use my money to do a pilot project and this man refused to support this, how am I going to recuperate my money back? But people take risks and they will use their money to do the pilot, and eventually the producer will come through with loads of money and say, go ahead, I am loving what I'm saying. But it takes risks. At the same time, people have taken such a risk and the money has not been recouped because the producer pulled out. Oh yes, many times it has happened to me. But that is not mean you have to stop. You have to continue to learn on every stage in life where there's an obstacle. What causes this obstacle? What can I do to overcome this kind of obstacle? And that is when we bring what we call power of negotiation. Even for the pilot project, you will add your budget to it and then you will take 50%. So the loss will be 50% for you, 50% for the producer, in case he pulled out. And if he didn't pull out, all of you gain 50% more. Praise God, somebody. So I am saying, obstacle that you see today should not make you to throw in the towel. Rather, it should make you to use the towel to clean the brow in your house, like in your face, like this, and then look for the way to move forward. Exodus 14, 15 to 16. Then the Lord said to Moses, why are you crying to me? Tell the people to get moving. In fact, I love that word. To get moving. Pick up your staff and raise your hand over the sea. Divide the water so Israel can walk through the middle of the sea. If they have not ready, or they have no hope that the water can divide, God didn't give them what he was going to do. He just said, why are you looking at me? Yeah, come on, gather yourself, move forward, and you do this. And because of they have faith, because they're ready to take risks, the water parted. I am saying to somebody, the water that has been preventing you, the obstacle that has been preventing you, will be removed for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Just, amen.
I'm not sure what is your own problem. Yours could be geographical obstacle. It shall be removed in the name of Jesus. Yours could be human obstacle, like Pharaoh that was chasing them. The Pharaoh you see today, you will see him no more in the name of Jesus. I pray that everything that is blocking your way will be removed in the name of Jesus. Geographical hindrances will be removed. Human hindrances will be removed. Hindrances will be removed. Face upon you will be removed. Adjustment to block you will be removed. In that number four, to go forward means that the future obstacle shall be taken care of and be removed completely. It sounds the same, but it's not the same. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 7 to 9. Zechariah chapter 4, verses 7 to 9. He said, who are you, O great mountain before Zerubbabel? You shall become a plain, and he shall bring forth the capstone with a shout of grace to it. 8. Moreover, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, look at this, said, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this temple. His hand shall also finish it. Then you will know the Lord of hosts has sent me. I am saying to somebody, every abandoned project that you think you have no money to complete, every project that you have already conceived in your heart, the Lord will help you, because that is a foundation. You will complete it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You don't understand what I'm saying. I have somebody that is sharp that can give me a resounding amen. I said, every great mountain before you will become plain in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Will be complete in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every enemy known to you or unknown to you who are waiting in your future shall fall before you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You like it or not, whenever God gives you opportunity to go back to your country, I don't know where you come from, if in Nigeria or whatever, I don't care. But what I'm saying is, when you are going, you will go with a bale of money to give to your enemy. you. They are coming to bring their problem to you to say, look, man, the Lord has blessed you. Please. And that, and the Lord will do it for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Listen to me. When the Israelites were going, there were so many things that were blocking their way. Number one was a city called Jericho. And the Lord gave them what to do, and the wall of Jericho came down. I am saying to you, every wall of Jericho in your way will fall in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Not only that, if you read Exodus properly, you will see that they came and they met somebody called a satanic prophetic called Balaam and Balak, who tried to block their way and place a curse over them. Every satanic prophet that is standing in your way, that say you will not achieve anything when they are alive, I am saying to you that the Lord in their presence, the Lord will anoint you afresh, your cup will run it over, and in the presence of your enemy, and you become untouchable. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh my God, every future obstacle to you become a stairs to your success.
Amen.
Amen. To go for a means, do not be afraid. I will be with you. Some of us, what is killing us is fear. Fear of tomorrow. Fear of how to make the ends meet, fear of what my family will eat, fear of what my children will become. In the real sense of it, all these things that you have, it is not yours. If you believe in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, Matthew 6, 33, in your own time, go and read that, what it says. He said, commit your way unto the Lord, and every other thing we do will be added unto you. When you know that something is not yours, you don't have fear to give it out. When you see yourself as a channel of blessing, you don't need to wait for people to ask for money before you bless them. When you see yourself as a channel of blessing, you don't need anybody to preach for you before you know what to do. When you see yourself, and what is not enough today, I am saying to somebody, it's going to come and become plenty in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Do not be afraid, I will be with you. Genesis chapter 26, verse 33. Genesis 26, verse 3. It said, live here as a foreigner in this land, and I will be with you and bless you. I hereby confirm that I will give you all this land to you and your descendants, just as solemnly promised Abraham your father. Again, Genesis 31, 3. Genesis 31, 3. Then the Lord said to Jacob, return to the land of your father and your grandfather, to your relative there. I will do what? I will be with you. Joshua 1, 5 said, no one will be able to stand against you as long as you live. For I will do what? I will be with you as I was with Moses. I will not fail you. I will not abandon you. Isaiah chapter 40 verse 10 says, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold up your hand with victorious right hand. And I am saying to somebody that today, the Lord will help you. The Lord will hold your hand. Every prayer that you pray, the Lord will give answer to it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hey, brethren, you have to determine to take a step of faith. You have to determine to do more for God. You have to determine to just move forward. It is not enough for you to hear it. It is not enough for you to pray it. But then there's something we call prophetic action. It is time for you to rise up where you are and take an action and say, I am moving forward this year. I said, don't allow fear to keep you in the same place. You have been there for so many years. Oh, I want to do this is because of lack of paper. I want to do that is because of lack of this. I was planning to do this, but then things changed. Stop giving excuses. It's time for you to do what? To rise up and ask God to take you by the right hand, to bring success to you. And so will he do for you and your family in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
To go for all means that the promises for you shall never fail. I will do what? I will fulfill all of them. This is what God says. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 13 and 14. Hebrews 6, 13 and 14. For when God made a promise, to Abraham, because he could swear by no one greater. He swore by himself, saying, surely, blessing I will bless you, and in multiplying I will multiply you. I am saying to somebody, God has already God has already used his name to swear, and he's saying to you, Isaac, he's saying to you, Adesanya, he's saying to you, Ronke, he's saying to you, James, that in blessing I will bless you, in multiplying I will multiply you, and every one under the sound of my voice, so shall the Lord do for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Seed, and he has said this to your father. And you know, one thing with God is a God of covenant. He will carry the covenant from one generation to another. And it is now your generation. It is now your time. It is now your season. And I am saying to you, move forward in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God promises to you. You see, one of our challenges is we don't take time to study the Bible, so we don't know the promises of God for you and I. What are the promises? In Joshua chapter 1 verse 5, he said, I will be with you. Read it in your own time. In Isaiah 43 verse 2 and Psalm 91 verse 13, he said, I will protect you. Again, in Psalm 34 verse 10, Psalm 34, he said, I will provide for your needs.
Amen.
That is what he said. So number seven, to go forward means that God will snatch away those who are destined to die right away from the jaw of death in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Not die before your time.
Which,
after the power of COVID-19, you will be among those who will live to testify to what the Lord has done.
Amen. Amen.
Understand? The people that died cannot testify.
Amen.
That are alive that can testify to the goodness of God during this
day. In the
mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. I will testify.
Hey, what did I say? In Isaiah 43, verse 4, you will see that God exchanged the hunter for the hunt. In the mighty name of Jesus, everyone that is hunting your life, God, there will be in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
God exchanged the wicked of Aman for the Jews. In the name of Jesus, every hole, everything that they have dig along your path, they will be the one to fall into it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Chapter 2, verse 19. Herod was seeking to kill baby Jesus, but God come through for him. I am saying to you, if enemy has written concerning you the time that you are going to die, they will be the one to replace you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
So, everyone in contact with Jesus, they were raised to life. So that is why I have no problem when you are telling me that you are unwell, you are sick. Because God will bring everything that is dead in your life to life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your body will come back to life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
For your time in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
To go forward means that God is about to begin a chain of reaction that will lead you from one level of miracle to another. You see what happened to the Israelites in the story that we just read? They crossed the Red Sea, that's the first miracle. Their enemy perished, that's the second miracle. In their journey, they came to a place where they call Mara, which is bitter water, but that bitter water turned to sweet. I am saying to you, every bitterness in your life will turn to sweet in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Where miracle has never happened, that we can see water gushing out of a rock. Through them, they saw that. I am saying the miracle that your family has never experienced before, the Lord will do it for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
To a place where manna was falling down from heaven. They do not need to go and sow. They do not need to go and harvest. The manna was just falling down and they were eating. I don't know the manna you are asking God for this morning, but everything that you desire will reach your hand without hard labor in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will move from one level of miracle to another, that by the time testimony. At the beginning of the month, people will be asking, Shewone, are you the only one here? Why are you just testifying? Do you want to take all the time? And that will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying? I say you will experience the kind of breakthrough that your family experienced before in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's try and quickly bring this forward. But number nine, to a close. Number nine, to go forward means keep moving until your jaw is full. Do not rest. Keep moving. John chapter 16, verse 24. John 16, 24, I'm reading Passion. He said, until now, you have not been bold enough to ask the Father for a single thing in my name. But now, you can ask and keep on asking, and you can be sure that you will receive what you ask for, and your joy will have no limit. I am saying to somebody, as you are going to go into a prayer session, and you are going to open your mouth to ask, everything that you are going to ask this morning, the Lord will do for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 7, verse 7 to 8. Matthew chapter 7, verse 7 to 8. Say, ask, and the gift is yours. You know, something can just be in the house that you need, and you are looking at it and you are desiring it. Unless you ask, you won't get it. So God is saying to you and I in Matthew 7, 7, he said, ask and the gift is yours. Seek and you will discover. Knock and the door will be open for you. 8, he said, for every persistent one will get what he asked for. It's not for everybody. It's for every persistent ones that we get what they are asking for. I have told you about my uncle when he got a mortgage on his property, and the plan and everything on that property is with the bank, and all of a sudden the bank collapsed, in that country. Everything just collapsed, and he started praying and asking God for a whole year, from January to December. I said, God, I want the paper for my property. I don't know how you are just one single prayer point for a whole year. In December of that same year, they set up a committee to be able to retrieve some money in and give people their paper. And they receive a call to say, come, we want to discuss your mortgage. And they asked him to pay half of what he remained. And he was negotiating. He said, I cannot afford that because this is the year that I am supposed to pay this money gradually. How dare you asking me to pay half? I will pay so amount. And they started negotiating. And what he desired to pay was what he was asked to go and pay. Is that not a miracle? And they even gave him his paper before they received the check. Can you see God working here? But you have to be what? You have to be consistent. The problem with our generation is we like microwave. We are not consistent in cooking. Everything must be microwave, ready, steady, go. No, God is not like that. He wants to test you. He wants to try you. He wants to search your heart. He wants to know that do you truly love him, or is it because of what you need? So you're persistent in seeking him, you're persistent in praying, you're persistent in knocking the door, you're persistent in seeking, you're persistent in asking, we make your miracle to reach your hand. James chapter 4 verse 2, James chapter 4 verse 2, I'm still reading TPT, which is the Passion Translation. It says, you jealously want what others have, so you begin to see yourself as better than others. So he's telling us our heart. If my heart is to be like Brother Isaac with what he has, you know that he just bought a jet stream. You know what that is? A private plane. And then I desire to say, because Isaac has just bought a private plane, I have to go and get a private plane. God will not give it to me because my intention is to be equal with him. God might have given him that private jet for his work, for a particular reason. So don't say somebody is wearing a kind of special jeans, Levi, and because of that, you only have 20 pounds, and you know that Levi is about 120, so you want to stress yourself to go and get 120 jeans. To me, jeans is jeans. It is what you wear, how you carry yourself that matters. It's not what you are putting on. Praise God, somebody. Okay.
Hallelujah.
To scheme with every envy and harm others, to selfishly obtain what you crave. That's why you quarrel and fight. So if you are unable to achieve it, you start fighting Isaac. You start saying you won't even give somebody a lift in his jet stream. Why? Have you asked yourself the intent of your heart? For anyone that will get the success ahead, you must be thankful at what he has given unto you. Hello? For everyone that will get the success ahead, you must see yourself as happy and trusting God to do more. And you know what? Every step that you take, at every point in time, at every junction, God always releases what you need for you. Because you know that if he gives you earlier than that time, you will either squander it or that thing will kill you. Do you know why some of us hasn't gotten our miracle? It's because we can't handle it. We're seeing you in church now. Let God decorate you with few pounds, thousands. Then you will say, oh, sorry, pastor, I have to be in Malaysia for my business. I have to be in Hong Kong. I just actually came by. I'm so sorry that I can't make the meeting. I know I was on the, you put my name on the timetable, but I was too busy. I couldn't even call. I was in a meeting. I hope the services went well. That's what you are going to say. And God knew that is not what he wants. That is why he hasn't answered you. When you are asking him, look for the intent of your heart. What is the intent? What do you need it for? Do you really think? And if you think you don't need it, why do you ask for it? You don't help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, let us go to God and ask him to have mercy. Where we have missed it, so that the success and the prayer we want to pray, the Lord can answer us. I want to give us a few time to just say, Father, have mercy on me.
The point.
Oh, have mercy on me, Lord God Almighty. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray for mercy.
I have missed
the point of blessing that you have given unto me. Have mercy. A prayer of mercy is not a quiet prayer, brethren. I know that we are not.
My father,
pointed at my destiny this year, wither by fire and die in Jesus' name. Every evil.
Let that hand be withered in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Father.
Father,
connect me to the destiny helpers.
Connect me to the destiny helpers.
Bring success before the end of this year to me in Jesus' name.
Before the end of this year, oh Lord, Father, in the name of Jesus, connect me to my destiny, in the mighty name of Jesus, before this end of this year, oh Lord, even before the end of this month, oh Lord, you can do it, oh Lord, you can do it, oh Lord, connect me, oh Lord, connect my children, connect me, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, to our destiny, helper, in the mighty name of Jesus, connect me, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord,
in the
mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. Connect me to my destiny, Eva. Connect my children to their destiny, Eva. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Amen.
We are going to cry to God to show you the way and connect you to your success. What do I mean by that? I was just reading a story of a young boy. I think he's about 18 now. Yes, he's about 18 now. And as of yesterday, the company that he started as a joke in his father's garage was snatched up by an American company that is now giving him the worth of the company now is $9.5 million. You know what that means? Stop to go to school. He can never, ever, ever become poor again. That's what it simply means. So you. They are creative miracle. They are things that God has given unto you. Let it be solution that the world need to bring you prosperity. Say, my father.
My father.
To the world's problem. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and pray. Father, make me a solution to the world problem.
Father, make me a solution to the world problem in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, make me a solution to the world problem in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, so Lord, I pray to you, O Lord, that make me a solution. In Jesus' name, amen.
And if God bless you with a dream and he told you what to put together and you put those things together, and that is the solution to COVID-19. Do you know that the government will speak to you? Hello? No matter the color of your skin, the government will call you to a meeting because they know that you have something that the world is desperate for. You know how much medication that UK has bought? We haven't tried the medication yet. We are not sure if it's going to work yet, but yet they have committed so much money into those development. But when God make you a solution to the world's problem, they will look for you and talk to you. And I want you to open your mouth and say, my father, give me
my
need. That will become a solution to the world problem.
Make me a solution to the world problem of this world. You know it, O Lord. You can repeat it to me as you repeat to the Daniel and the problem of the king. Oh Lord, my God, I call you, O Lord, that you make me a way of solution to the problem of this nation. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Last prayer, you are going to pray to God. I will not die before I reach my success. You know, so that you have to pray this prayer. Hold on. There is a property in a city in Nigeria. I will not mention the city. The property is on top of a rock or a mountain. Billions will sink into that property. The day they are going to do what we call housewarming, that they are going to the day they are going to declare the property open, the day we are going to say this is the housewarming of this property. It was Babangida who was coming to declare the property open. Can I tell you that the one that built that property died that same morning? I am not joking. Yes, he died the same morning. Babangida has already left Abuja, so he came all alone. But not for the housewarming now, but for the burial of this man. The same day, you are going to cry to God. On the day of my joy, the day of my joy, the day of my breakthrough, I will not die before that. I will not die that day in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray, somebody. Pray. The day of joy, the day of success. It will not be the day that I will die. No. No. I reject it. Every handwriting of the enemy, everything that the enemy has put in place, that the day of my joy will be the day that I will die. No, I reject it in Jesus' name. Oh, brethren, permit me to sing this song. If you know it, please sing along. Oni ojoto taru. Lati pa milekun ojo yen ni baba so dojo aye. Please allow me to pray to use this as a prayer point. Ojo totaro lati pa milekun ojo yen ni baba so dojo ayeye. Ojo totaro lati gbare ayo mi ojo yen ni ba. The day that enemy has thought is the end of your life, that is the day that God will turn around as a day of your celebration. Turn that into your prayer. I said, the day enemy has written down concerning me, the day that said that I will leave this world, the day that said it will be the day I find myself in jail, let it be the day of my ceremony. Let it be the day of my honor. Let it be the day that people of the world will know that I serve a God. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray. Oh, the day that the enemy has set aside to say, my hand has come, it will be the day, Lord, that you are going to tell them that you haven't finished with me. In the mighty name of Jesus, go ahead and pray. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, 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 pray. Pray that God, oh, you will not be put to shame. 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 The day that enemy has thought is your last day. That is the day that
God. I will not be put to shame, Daddy, in the name of Jesus Christ. I will not suffer shame on the day of my glory in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, on the day of my celebration, I will not be missing in the name of Jesus Christ. The day of my coronation, I will not be found wanting or missing in the name of Jesus. Brethren, begin to pray and begin to declare on your day of unveiling, you will not be missing the success or ahead that God has proclaimed for you. You will enter into it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. On your day of joy, you will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. The success ahead, the day that God is going to announce you to the world, you will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. When you begin to tell the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ, the day of my children's success, they will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, the day of success that is ahead for my household, Daddy Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, we will not be missing, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. What kills my mate before their time will not take us away in the name of Jesus Christ. Brethren, open your mouth and begin to pray. Maleke baba kenteria mama kende. Malike ba In the name of Jesus Christ, on my day of celebration, Lord, on my day of being appreciated, Lord, that in the name of Jesus Christ, I will not be missing. In the name of Jesus Christ, the glorious destiny you have placed ahead of me, Daddy, Lord Jehovah, none will be used to replace me. In the name of Jesus Christ, Esau exchanged his birthright. My beautiful birthright will not be taken away from me. In the name of Jesus Christ, the day to receive the Father's blessing, Lord, I will not be missing, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, Christian, open your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus Christ. My leg, Baba Kenteria, my birthright will not be snatched away from me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my leg, Baba Mama Kende, the day of the bottom floor blessing, Lord, the greatest blessing, Lord, I will not be missing, Lord. In the name of Jesus, my children shall not be missing, my spouse shall not be missing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my leg, Baba Kende, on the day of the roll call for those to come and receive the great award, Daddy, in the name of Jesus Christ, we will not be missing, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, Maleke Bashkenteria Mama Kende, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want you also to stretch our hands to the man of God and begin to decree into his life that on the day of his success, he will not be missing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, on the day the person that bears the letter of good news will come to locate him, he will not be missing from his location. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Maleke Bashkenteria Mama Kende, let's begin to tell the Lord that his heart desire will reach his own hand as well. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, he will go forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally, financially, he will go forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's tell the Lord this morning that consigning him in 2020, that God will cause him to laugh in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that the blessing that he has been waiting for all this year, today, that this year 2020, it will be the day that God will bring it to full manifestation in his life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let's begin to pray. He will go forward. He will enter the success ahead that God has ordained for him. In the name of, that in this year 2020, they will use a new name to call him. In the name of Jesus Christ, let's begin to pray for one another. Let's begin to pray for every family on this forum this morning. And say, Lord, on the day of their glory, Lord, what takes their mate before their time will not take them away. Let's begin to pray and commit the JP family into the hands of the Lord, that the success ahead, he will not elude them. In the name of Jesus Christ, that which God has got in stock for them in the year 2020, the biscuit blessing, the biscuit healing, biscuit provision, they will not be missing. In the name of Jesus Christ, nobody will be used to replace them on the day of reward. In the name of Jesus Christ, let's begin to thank the Lord for this morning. Let's begin to thank the Lord for this word of encouragement this morning. I do not know how whatever you may be going through at this hour, but according to the word of God in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, it says it's just but for a moment. It says it is brief. It says it is light. That I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, that as God has called it, so shall it be. In the name of Jesus Christ, I want to encourage someone this morning with that scripture, 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, and I'm reading for the TPT translation. And then, after your brief suffering, the Lord God, the God of all loving grace, who has called you to share in his eternal glory in Christ, will personally and powerfully restore you. I speak to someone this morning, whatever thing you may be going through right now, as the written word of God that has been said to, you will powerfully restore in the name of Jesus Christ. God will personally restore you this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Not only will you be restored, you will be made stronger in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive unprecedented strength to conquer and recover all in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, in the name of Jesus Christ. And he will set you in your firm places and build you up. I decree over someone on this forum this morning, the Lord Jehovah will build you up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He will give you the manna from his word to build you up, to make you build spiritual muscle this day. In the name of Jesus Christ, the encouragement that you need, as Peter need, as David needed the encouragement to recover all that was stolen, tomorrow. You shall receive it this day in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for this morning, Lord. We give you praise, Lord Daddy. Thank you for powerfully restoring us, Lord. In the name of, thank you for building us up in your own wisdom, Lord. Daddy, we bless your holy name. Thank you because we are going forward. Daddy, in the name of Jesus, we are not retreating. We are not surrendering. We are not looking back. In the name of Jesus Christ, we continually look to Jesus, who is ahead of us, who will give us the victory at last that we need. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless your name, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Pastor Yomi, thank you for the word this morning. May the Lord bless you. May he increase you. May he continually give you wisdom and deep revelations in the name of Jesus Christ. Church, what an awesome day. I celebrate every one of you that's online this morning.
Thank you for allowing me to speak to you today. I hope you are blessed by this message. Visit our website for further information. You can also follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook, or even subscribe free on YouTube. God bless you real good.